if we multiply with the 2, is it these 2 applicable only for one element or both elements? Mathematics.
Both, sir.
Both. Now 2 into A, 2A, and 2 into B, 2B. Is it correct or not?
2B.
Yes or no? Now, you have here H2O. Yes. H2O you have. Now, you multiply both the things with 2. What will become, you tell me? 2 into 2.
What 2
into 2 will become 4. And 2 into 1.
4.
Yes, that means 1 will be there. 2 into 1, 2. Is it okay? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Understood now?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So that's all. Now, if you'll observe in this one, who is unbalanced now? Oxygen or hydrogen? Who is unbalanced now?
Hydrogen.
Which side? Reactants.
Sir, I have a doubt.
Reactants are product side.
Product.
Reactants are product side.
Sir, I have a doubt. Sir.
Product side, sir.
Ray, product sir, side is 2 ra, here 2 ra. Which side it is less ra? Always less side it is unbalanced.
Sir, while balancing, can we do it in the reactant side?
Anytime, any side you can do, not only the products. Reactant side or product side, any side you can do. Before here, product side it is less, so that
we can multiply. Which is?
Now you observe, hydrogens, here 2 and here 4. So we have to balance these 2. 4
cannot. Sir, which place it is less?
That is what always you remember. 4 cannot become 2, but 2 can become 4 by multiplying the some number. What is that number?
2, sir.
2. So step 2. Step 2, you write hydrogen, you have to multiply with understanding 2 plus O2. 2H2 plus O2 will give you 2H2. Is it correct or not? Yes or no? Yes or no, Ram?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now, this side no changing. So I will write exactly same thing. 2, 4 and 2. And product side, now reactant side, you check it. I am keeping here 2. 2 into 2, which is equals to 4. Oxygens are not changing. So 2 only will come. So now you verify. Hydrogens, 4 and 4. Understanding? And oxygens, 2 and 2. Is it equal or not?
Yes, sir.
Is it equal or not? Is it equal or not? Yes. So that I can say that what is the balanced chemical equation here? So the balanced chemical equation is, what is the balanced chemical equation? 2H2 plus O2, which will give you 2H2. Is it okay, Dab? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So that is the way of balancing. Padmavarshini, I will say you, don't worry. Now I will say you one more example, then only we will solve so many examples, then you can understand. Understand? So this is the way of balancing chemical equation. So this is the example one.
Sir.
Yeah, tell me, Ram.
Teach that last step. Teach that last step, sir.
You want only last step?
Yes, sir, only last step, sir.
Who is that? Who wants last step? Dina Dalan?
Yes, sir.
Dina, in step one, we are balancing oxygen. So I am trying to balance the oxygen. So I am trying to balance the oxygen here. Number of hydrogens also changing. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So number of hydrogens become 4 in the product side and oxygens become 2. So now if you'll observe reactant side, no change in step 1. So that 2 and 2 only writing. Now if you'll observe, number of hydrogens are product side are 4, but reactant side are 2 only. So now is it balanced or unbalanced?
Unbalanced.
Unbalanced. So unbalanced. This side it is going to balance now. Reactant side or product side? Here 4 and here 2.
Reactant
side. So that product side not changing. Exactly, I will write the same thing. And reactant side, 2 must become 4. So some number I have to multiply. Which number?
2.
2. That's all. I am multiplying with the 2 hydrogens. So that here I am multiplying hydrogen with the 2. Is it any change in oxygen? Is it any change in oxygen?
No.
Here oxygen is there. Is it any change in oxygen?
Sir.
No change. Correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Understand, Dina?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah.
Now, is it balanced or not? No, you verify. Number of hydrogens are 4. Number of oxygens are 2. Total number of atoms are 6 here. And here also, number of hydrogens are 4. And number of oxygens are 2. Total number of atoms are 6. So, is it balanced or not balanced?
Balanced, sir. Understood.
Balanced. That's all. Understanding?
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So, now, let us go for one more example. Then you people can understand more better. Understand? So, now, try to balance the equation of, can I erase it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, no, sir.
You try to write, man. What will happen? Nothing will happen. If I erase also, nothing will happen. Understand? So, okay. Right, we'll see only balancing chemical equation only. That is what I'm saying. Now, go for the next equation. So, let's do it now.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Write the next equation, balancing. Next, one more easy equation only. Okay. CH4, methane, write the equation. Methane reacting with oxygen. So, methane reacting with oxygen means what will happen? What is the methane formula? Methane.
CH4.
Methane
CH4.
Reacting means burning. Methane reacting with oxygen means it is burning reaction with the oxygen. So, let us go for now. Word equation, tell me. What will happen? Methane plus oxygen. Methane plus oxygen, which will give you, understanding, a product as carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide plus water. What we used to call ra? Carbon dioxide plus?
Water.
Now, chemical equation, tell me. Methane formula is CH4. What we used to call? Methane formula is?
CH4
plus oxygen. Oxygen, what is the symbol?
O2.
O2, which will give you carbon dioxide what?
CO2
plus H2O. Yes. Water is?
CO2 plus H2O.
Yes. Understanding? Now, you observe very carefully. Is it balanced or unbalanced?
Unbalanced, sir.
Unbalanced. Because see, number of oxygens are 2. Number of carbons are, understanding? No, sorry. Number of carbons are 1. But number of oxygen, see, this side 2. But this side how many? 2 plus 1. How many?
3.
3.
So, is it balanced or unbalanced?
Unbalanced equation.
Now, so let us go for balancing chemical equation. So, construct the table, all of you. Start doing now. Step 5 is what we have done. First step. What is the first step? Serial number. Understanding. Name of the element. Next one. Reactants. Number of atoms in reactant side, number of atoms in product side. So, very simple. So, if you'll understand that one, then you can do this one very, very easily. So, now start solving. So, what is the serial number 1? What is the elements? Tell me fast. Others also should speak. Communication is most important now.
C.
What is the elements are observing? C means what? Carbon. Next. Element 2.
Carbon.
Hydrogen. Next. Element 3.
Oxygen.
That's all. Correct or not? Clear any doubt, anybody? Only 3 elements are there. Is it correct or not?
No, sir.
No. Now, number of atoms of carbon in reactant side. Tell me, reactants are how many are there?
Sir, 1, 4, 2, sir.
Carbon how many?
1, sir. 1.
Number of hydrogens?
1.
Number of hydrogens?
4.
Number of oxygens?
4, sir.
Number of oxygens?
2,
sir.
2. Now,
2.
Yeah. Make a box. Next. Like that product side, you write. Number of carbons? 1. Number of hydrogens?
1.
Only 2. Number 2. Of oxygens? 3.
3.
Number of oxygens are how many?
3.
3. Now, this is the first step. Clear any doubt, anybody? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Now, observe very carefully. Here, how many atoms are unbalanced? Only 1 or 2 are unbalanced?
2 atoms, sir.
2 atoms are unbalanced. Correct or not? First carbon, carbon 1 and 1. Oh, balanced. Nice. Next, hydrogen here 4 and here 2 only. So it is unbalanced. Next, oxygen here 2 and 3. So it is also unbalanced. Sir, now question. Sir, how to balance it now? Is it correct or not? Which one is we have to balance? Either hydrogen or we have to balance with oxygen.
Sir, product needs.
What ra? Tell me ra.
Sir, nothing sir.
Yeah. Now if you observe.
Sir, nothing sir.
Always you see how to balance this one means select any one, hydrogen or oxygen. So which one you will select? Shall we select with oxygen?
Yes sir.
Shall we select with oxygen?
Sir,
or
we
hydrogen?
Hydrogen.
Hydrogen. So hydrogen means one step will increase more. Understand? So let us go for it now. Hydrogen only. They ask hydrogen, we will solve with the hydrogen. Now, here, side will change now. Product side or reactant side? Product side or reactant side?
Product side.
Product side.
Product side.
Product side. So now, reactant side, nothing will change.
Product
exactly side. Right. Exactly right like this. Product side, reactant side, nothing change. So step 2 also will come same thing. Now product side, what you will do? 4 is there, become 2. 2 needs to become 4. So what we will do?
2, sir.
What we will do?
4. 2 to sir, 4.
That's
two,
2. In
we'll
the 2, multiply
with
two.
The 2.
2 times.
Multiply with the 2. That's all. So now observe very carefully.
2 H2O.
Yes. 2 H2O.
2 H2O.
So that is the step 1. So CH4 plus O2, which will give you CO2 plus 2 H2O. Now, number of atoms in reactant side, product side, tell me all. All of you tell me, what is the number of atoms in reactant product side? I multiplied with the 2.
CO2 plus 2.
Carbon how many?
2 H2O.
Hey, carbon how many? Ra?
Carbon
1.
Hydrogens? 2 into 2.
Hydrogen
2 into 2.
4.
4. Now, if you multiply with the 2, here oxygen is also multiplied. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes,
sir.
Yes, sir. No. Now, total number of oxygens are how many?
4, sir.
Total number of oxygens are how many?
3.
3.
Three. Here, 4, three. Sir. 4, sir.
How many, ra?
4, sir.
Total number of oxygens are 4. See now, I have tried to balance the hydrogen, but oxygen also number of atoms are increases. Increases or not? Yes or no?
Sir, I can't understand the last. I can't understand last.
Number of oxygens you see, number of oxygens are how many? Here 2. And here 2 into 1, 2. 2 plus 2, how much?
Okay, sir.
Understood or not?
Okay, sir. I understood, sir.
Yeah, now.
Understood, sir.
Again, start checking. Number of carbons, 1 and 1. Number of hydrogens, 4 and 4. But number of oxygens, here 2 and here 4. Now, which side we have to balance it? Reactant side or product side? Reactant side or product side?
Reactant side. Reactant side.
So, product side, what we have to do? Product side, what we have to do? Exactly, we have to write it. Understanding? Exactly, we have to write it. Whatever the side which we are not going to do balancing, we have to write in the same thing. Now, product side. 4, 2 must become 4. So, which number we have to multiply?
2, sir.
2, sir. 2 or 2, sir.
That's all. So, CH4
plus 2O2.
2O2
plus
CO2
plus 2H2O.
Yes, sir. Understood all of you?
Yes. Sir. Hello, sir.
That's all. So, now, number of atoms in this side, tell me. Reactant side. 1, 4,
1, 4,
4.
2, 4, 4.
Now, you verify. Carbons, 1, 1. Hydrogens 4-4, oxygens 4-4. So is it balanced or not?
Yes, balanced.
So then, what is the balanced equation of this one? So CH4 plus
2. CH4 plus 2O2 plus 2H2O.
That is the balanced chemical equation. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
How many of you understood this?
Yes, sir.
I have understood, sir.
Yeah.
Understood.
Any doubt means anybody who asks me. Again, see. If you are responding only, it is good for me. If not, you people cannot understand. Later, it is very, very difficulty. That is what I'm saying. All of you do it. And if you're not understanding, ask me.
Hello, sir.
Then they'll tell me. Tell me, Ra. Now, shall I go for next equation?
Yes, sir.
All of you. If you are ready, okay. I will go. Shall I say?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, you try to balance it. Let me see. I will give you 2 minutes time also. Right. Decomposition of potassium chloride. Decomposition of potassium chloride. I will say what is decomposition also. Just write the equation. Decomposition of potassium chloride. Decomposition of potassium chlorate. Right. Decomposition of potassium chloride. That is the equation. What is the word equation, right? Word equation. All of you. Word equation. Word equation. Potassium chlorate. Right, I will say. You people don't know. I know that. No issues. Right. Potassium. Potassium chlorate. ChlorAT. Potassium chloride, if we'll start heating amma, understand? Heating. Then we used to get potassium chloride. Understanding? Potassium chloride. Potassium chloride. ChlorID. Chloride plus oxygen gas will come. Oxygen will come. Is it okay, amma? Is it okay or not? Now, KC, write the equation I am writing. KClO3 is the potassium chloride formula. KClO3, chemical equation, which will give you potassium chloride is KCl plus oxygen is O2. Now, try to balance this and tell me. Let me see who will say. Potassium chloride.
Every equation.
Potassium chloride is KClO3. Cl is 1, chlorine, KClO3. Product is potassium chloride. KCl plus O2. Try to balance it and tell fast.
Sir, oxygen or hydrogen, it will come only in gas or atom.
What, amma?
Sir, here it is atom or it is gas. No, sir. In every equation, whether we have to take it as gas.
Gas only, amma. Oxygen, ah?
Sir.
Ajika,
how to find whether it... No, sir. In every equation, how to find whether atom or gas is given, sir?
Atom or gas, sir? It is atomicity. No, have sir. You studied atomicity? Class 8, I only have it. I have taught you. Atomicity. Class 9 also it came. Monoatomic molecules, yes, diatomic sir. Molecules. Yes, sir. No, Ashika?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I will teach you that also. No problem. You try to balance this one first. Try to balance and tell me. All of you try to do it. I will verify your notes also. Humaira, Nitish, no response. Prahasini, Pranav. This much time, very simple, correct. Tell me fastly. Arya. Tell me.
KCl plus O.
What is the element? What is the element? First element. Elements tell me. What is the elements are present? First element. First element. Potassium.
K.
Yeah. Second element.
K.
Chlorine. Third
Cl.
Element. Oxygen. Is it correct? Yeah, others. Nobody. So many is not responding. I don't know why. You can respond, yeah. Now. Reactants are tell me. Four. Reactants are how many K are there? How
one.
Many K are there?
KCl plus O6.
Wait, man. KCl. Cl how many? One. Oxygen how many?
Three.
1, 1, 3. Now product side tell me. Product side. Product
sir,
side.
Potassium one, sir.
Potassium one.
One.
This one.
One, three, sir.
Two.
Yeah, so this is the thing. Now, observe very carefully here. Understand? Now, K potassium 1 and 1. Now, chlorines are 1 and 1. Now, oxygens are 3 and 2. Sir, how to balance it now? This is a question mark everybody is having. Correct or not? Yes or no? Now, see. Observe very carefully.
Yes, sir.
If you will multiply the both the sides at a particular number, then the both will become equal. What is that number? You tell me. With the lowest numbers like 1, 2, 3. If you will multiply 3 with some number, it will become some number. Here 2 with some number, 1, 2, 3. It will become equal. What is that?
16 will come, sir.
Huh?
2, 3.
2, 3.
2 multiply so now, 3 into 2. And
anyhow,
2 into
3. First, starts with the reactants product side only. Because here 3 is there, here 2 is there. So now, I am trying to balance this one now. So let us go for product side, same thing. And the reactant side, same thing. 1, 1, 3. Now, product side, you see. Oxygens, I am trying to make it by multiplying the lowest possible number with the 3. I am making as 6. So now, what will become? Step 1. Step 1, all of you write. KCl plus 3O2, not O6, bad fellow, 3O2, O6 you cannot change, 2 should not change, only coefficient, is it okay?
Okay.
Now tell me, what is the number of atoms in product side? 1, 1 and 3 2s are how much?
6.
3 2s are how much?
6.
Six, sir.
That's all. Now, start verifying. 1 and 1. Next, 1 and 1. But here, see. Here, 3 and here, 6. So, which side we should balance now? Reactant side or product side?
Reactant side.
So, product side, you write clearly same thing. 1, 1, 6. Now, reactant side, 3 must become 6. So, which number we should multiply?
Reactant side, we can multiply with 2, sir.
With the 2. What we can multiply? Only oxygen or this
2,
full
sir.
Compound? Oxygen or this full compound? Oxygen or this full compound?
Full compound.
It is not possible to multiply oxygen only alone. So, full compound we will multiply. Understanding? Full compound.
Yes, sir. For full
so, now
compound.
You tell me.
Yes,
sir. So, this side no changing. So, now number of atoms you tell me. How many K's are there? Step 2. This is step 2.
2K.
2 K's are 2. Chlorines are how many?
2.
2. And oxygens are?
Sir, while writing, we have to put bracket.
Bracket not required. For your understanding, I am saying. For your understanding, I am saying.
Sir, now for products, okay. We can multiply it with
Wait. Let them understand everybody. Now, you try to balance the oxygen, but number of atoms are potassium and chlorine is also changing. Is it true or not? There is island, Nitesh. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now, potassium atoms become 2. Understanding? Chlorine atoms become 2. Oxygen becomes 6. But this side 1, 1, 6 only. So now, which side we should balance?
Product side.
So reactant side, no change. So directly you can write 2, 2, 2. Now, product side. Potassium, let us balance now potassium. Here 2 and here 1. So 1 will become 2. So which number I should multiply? Step 3.
Step 2 KCl.
Huh?
2 KCl.
Step 3. I will multiply as 2 KClO3, which will give you, I will multiply with the 2. Full product, I will multiply with the 2. So 2KCl plus 3O2. So now 2KCl means what? How many atoms of potassium? 2 potassium atoms.
2
chlorine atoms. Oxygens are how many? 6. Is it correct or not?
Sir, yes for no? Reactant side you change 2, sir.
Reactant side I have not changed anything. 2 to 6
Yes, sir.
Yes, this is the balanced equation. So the balanced equation of this potassium chlorate is 2KClO3, which will give you 2KCl plus 3O2. How many of you understood this equation? Any doubt in this?
Yes, sir.
All of you, others?
No, sir. I can't understand.
No, sir.
Who is not understanding, please? Pranita?
Me. Yes, sir.
Pranita, which step you not understand? Tell me.
Sir, last step alone, sir.
Last step, see. Last step, what is there? Here, chlorine is 2 and, potassium is also 2 and chlorine is also 2. But here, potassium is 1 and chlorine is also 1. So, you try to balance any one first. Let us take potassium alone. Now 1 must become 2. So which number you will multiply? 1 must become 2.
2, sir.
With the 2. So this
sir.
full compound, I cannot multiply only potassium. So full coefficient I will keep as a 2 here. Is it correct or not?
Yes, sir.
If I keep 2 here, this 2 is applicable only for potassium or chlorine also?
For potassium and chlorine also, sir.
That's all. So now potassium become 2, so as well as chlorine also will become 2 and oxygen become 6. So that's all.
Okay, sir.
Understood?
Mistake in question. Yes, sir.
Are you clear now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, that's all. So now, shall we go for next equation? Anybody?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I will write the equation directly. You try to balance it and tell me. Sir, this is the balanced chemical equation. Let me see who will say first. If you are able to speak, unable to speak, at least in chart, you tell me. Understand? Because balanced chemical equation is most important. And till I need to teach you tricks also. After the tricks only, I will leave you. Now write the equation. CO, carbon monoxide, reacting with water. Hydrogen, which will form... Understanding? Methyl alcohol or methanol? CH3OH. This is methanol, amma. Remember? Methanol. Now itself formula you run. Methanol. This is what? Hydrogen. And this is carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide. Now.
Sir, the board is not clear.
Okay. I will say. You see. CO. Carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide. Reacting with hydrogen H2, hydrogen H2, and it is forming CH3OH, methanol. So now try to balance it and tell me balance the chemical equation fastly. Very easy, only one step. If you do one step, you will get the answer. Balance. Tell me fast. Pranav, Nitesh, Arya, no response from you all. Anushree, Ashika is responding well. She is sending everything in chat. But I don't know others what is happening.
Sir, CO plus 2H2 gives CH3 plus OH4.
Padra.
Sir, wait.
No. Ray, you don't change the product, man. Chemical formula won't change. Only what it will change? Only change yes, in coefficient.
Yes, sir. CO plus H2.
Humaira answered. Very good, Humaira. CO plus? Very easy, simple equation.
2H2.
That's all. Nothing is going to change. Everything is common. So here if you observe, C is 1 and 1. Oxygen is also 1 and 1. But hydrogen is here 2. And here totally 3 plus 1, 4 are there. So what will happen? Only single step it will come. You have to multiply here with the 2. Now you see it is balanced. Correct or not? Tell me, R. Others also. So now, elements 1, carbon. Element 2, oxygen. Element 3, hydrogen. That's all. So now, products and reactants at C. 1 is there, oxygen sir. 1 and hydrogen sir 2. So now, this side, carbon is 1, hydrogen sir 3 plus 1, 4. Hydrogen sir 3 plus 1, 4. Oxygen is 1. So who is unbalanced here? Tell me fast. Who is unbalanced here?
Hydrogen.
Hydrogen. So here 4 is there, here 2 is there. So which side we have to balance? Oxygen. Reactant side or product
side?
Reactant side. Product side, same thing will come. 1, 1, 4. Product side, same thing will come. 1, 1, 4. Now reactant side. 2 is there. 2 must become 4. So what we have to do? 2 need to become 4. What we have to do?
2, sir.
2H2.
We have to multiply with the 2. That's all. So now, step 1, only one step it will get the answer. Step 1, you have to multiply with the 2. So if you multiply with the 2, what will happen? Number of carbons are not changing. Oxygens are not changing. But hydrogens 2 into 2 will become 4. That's all. So now you verify. 1 and 1. 1 and 1. Understanding? And 4 and 4. Is it balanced or not? Balanced or not?
Yes, sir.
That's all. So like this, sir, we have to do the balanced chemical equation by writing in the form of tabular column. So your textbook, they will write the stepwise column, but it will lead to the so many times it will commit to the mistakes. If you want, you check with your sir also. While he is solving, you observe how many times you people will get confused. Difference the atoms between, means the number of atoms between the reactant side and product side. So like this, if we'll write, you see, if we are, suppose we are changing reactant side, product side we are not changing, exactly we are writing. Is it correct or not? Yes or no? Yes or no? That is why if we write in the form of this kind of tabular column, then we don't have any kind of confusion and we people will solve very clearly and we'll get the correct answer always. So that is the importance of balanced chemical equation and how to balance the chemical equation. So now in this class, I have taught how to balance the chemical equation and all. So the next class I will say, understand, a biggest equations and all, how we can balance very simply with the help of, by using a tricks, small tricks. We have three tricks and with the examples also, I will teach you, understanding, in the next class. So with this, I'm going to stop now. Thank you.